The class can be about how to deal with leg locks. Huh? Well, that's actually simple. Don't give them your legs. So if I go with Raul, I will never in my life, never in my life in competition have I been put a single time in a De La Riva. I will never, well, not say it cannot happen. And more in the past than today, I have had people attacking my feet. And right now it still happens, but rarely. I think the last time I was in a footlock situation in competition is like 3 or 4 years ago on a naga competition, because I really had to hunt. Yeah? So think about this. If you put your feet on the floor, turtle is defense for everything. It's an average defense for everything, but you have to adapt it a little bit depending on what they do. Yeah. Now, what is the two quickest ways to victory? Is to do the guillotine, or to do the footlock. Yeah, and that's actually also the main difference between BJJ people and between Lutta Livre people in the past. Lutta Livre people are like came from the poorer districts where they fight for honor and glory. I imagine they go for the head and the feet right away. And if you're Jitsu is more the rich people, if you're like a rich proper person, you know, that's really how I see it. Yeah. So lay down, please. So what I will never do, I will never start fighting like this. Like, man, like we went to the ADCC competition, like in Belgium, and you see the guy being a footlocker and he's going to start his guard like that. Okay? And in a way, everybody in the world right now, most young guys, are doing these kind of passes. So everybody's game is also more geared towards attacking that kind of a guard. But it's very harder to deal with this. So what are the dangers if you fight on your knees? What are the main dangers? Well, they can get your head. They can get your head. So develop a good guillotine. I will not teach you today how to defend the guillotine, but I can give you the tools to learn good defense. And actually, it's the same that Chai said in this class as well. What are the tools to good defense? Is do a guillotine, please, very slowly, and finish me one time. Good. Okay? And now go there again, and right before you finish me, stop. Go for it more. So, no, stay there. I'm going to tap. Go like a tiny bit back, put pressure. Okay. And now I'm gonna do the minimum that I need to do, not to die. And then we start the fight, go. I died. Okay, so it was not the minimum I need to do, not to die. And you play around that area, and he has to learn to beat me with less control and less perfect grip, but it's not very complex there. It's like binary, that or no. But you'd be very slowly around it, and you figure it out by yourself. If you try to teach, for example, the hardest thing to teach people is to teach submissions, because it has to be very precise. If you teach an arm triangle, you should put like the perfect class of an arm triangle, and then it doesn't work. Why not? Well, maybe because his partner was in like a little bit different angle. So how you solve that? Well, how you solve defense in boxing? You punch my chin. Ah, oh, fuck. Go again. And you play the game, and sometimes you get hit, and you make it not too dangerous. Yeah. So but that's one of the dangers. So you have to solve the neck attacks, and usually it's like turning with the submission a little bit. What's the other thing that can happen here is a triangle. Well, triangle, I'm not going to teach the triangle defense class today, but you can find that online already, because that's one area you can take it. The other part which can happen is arm drags. See, when you drag the arm, boom, they start to attack your back. And then they can come up, and then you have to have good back defense. That's like the main areas. But what I will not do is go for my feet, please. Look, as long as he starts to, for example, go, put your arm underneath my leg. If he starts to do this, well, I should never allow him to go underneath. As long as I can keep my weight, here I'm in trouble, for sure. Go back, please. But if I'm already here, so try to take it now, I'm going to try to stuff that. Now, what is the danger? If I keep too far away and I go backwards, then this starts to happen. Okay, so I have to see, these are the limits you have to take your game in between. Come here, please. Now, what I'm usually going for, lay on your back, so I don't want, we can talk about when you sit up later. Yeah. So the hardest thing I found when I rode is just to get a grip on him. That's very hard. And if you have to be calm. And in competition, that really depends on the situation, referee, and all of things. My main idea to fight jiu-jitsu is to tire the guy out, make him shoot, waste his bullets. Yeah? If I could not move at all, I would do that. But because of referees, you have to move a little bit. So you have to see how far you can take the stalling. And if you can make points first, then it's not a problem to, like, if you have 2 points ahead, it's like you earned some credit and now you can pay a bit of penalties to the referee. Okay. Now, my main grip I use in gi is here. Remember the sword and shield class? They gave it. It's the same thing. I'm always doing that. This is my sword. This is my shield. And in medieval times, you strike with your shield and you parry with your, strike with your sword and you parry with your sword. And you can mostly defend with your shield, but you can also hit with your shield. So it's both offense and defense. And this is my main one I want to be. The arm underneath, then this is something you can, is quite readily available. Yeah. So I'm going to go for the underhook, and this arm is going to be here, inside the leg. And I always put pressure. And then I track. See? So then we're going to see, I'm going to give some of, so for example, if you're here, he puts the foot up, it becomes this. See? Good, bring the foot back inside. Yeah. If I want to do anything on me, he needs to get the foot inside, and it becomes very annoying. Yeah. You cannot pass a person when one foot is on you, you cannot progress. Once the foot is away, then you can start to progress. So the first thing I want you guys to do right now is you have to get an underhook, get the, how you call this, the combat base position, and then don't allow this foot to touch you. I'm going to be here, so I'm going to let it do very relaxed, boom. Goes here, goes there, boom. The foot goes inside. No, bring the foot inside. It goes here. Put your foot on me. This is actually probably good, but this happens a lot. See, so if you're here, what mostly gi people do is that they try to grab the pants. And then when I grab, you can grab my wrist and my elbow is open. Mm. And that's a very bad thing. I want to get a closed elbow. Yeah. So whenever the foot is here, that's a gi way. They get the pants. And then they get frustrated. And the no-gi way is always to do this, to pummel inside and to catch the foot, correct? But what happens, I push and you will pummel back inside.
Yes.
So you keep playing this silly game until one of the two randomly gets control. So what I do when this happens, I go inside and I put Napoleon. Mm-hmm. Napoleon? Mm-hmm. We know him because the Belgians defeated him. Waterloo, it's history, don't. So you go here. So and now you bring yourself up, you start to stack. What we're going to do? Bring the foot out and you keep pumping. So I'm never going to go for the grip here. Not never, but that's the idea. So play a little bit. Up, up. Walks on, walks off. He goes inside, put the foot. If you pull harder, see that. See, then, okay, then we have to. Then maybe we grab. The foot comes here, boom. Go inside. Use your core. We start stacking. You put pressure away and walk again. We'll talk about this leg later, okay? Hey guys, time. So look, we now did, this is the hardest part. Why is it hard? Because, well, it's the most complex part. A million things can, if I'm far away from my hood, I can jump around, I can turn around, I can do this, and nothing doesn't really affect the fight, but I have like a million options. And the more we go close to each other, the less it gets to pay out. So in general, that was, I'm considered a slow fighter. I don't think I'm slow, I'm just as fast as I need to be. No, but it's important. Because to take it to a very extreme, I see some young guys and I have like many examples, they go like they drill. Imagine you're a very beginner, huh? They drill this over there and I see them literally do this. Go in here and bump. No points, nothing. What the hell? Yeah, the point is to control and don't give anything. And the rules make it so you have to. I hate the rule of stalling, it doesn't make any sense whatsoever. If you see any MMA fight, the more boring the fight is, the more likely you want to be in that fight. And the more spectacular, the better for the watcher, but the less good for the guy who's in the fight. Yeah. So, and I will give you a good pointer about this or this. So I can only say I put the heel on the floor, but and then when I go forward, I actually put the heel up. So but play with that. Yeah. But it's important though is to keep this space closed. You don't want to give it open. Mm. Yeah. Basically, in any case, every single submission that there is always going to be easier if I go away from you. A long time ago, in a galaxy far away, when they used to put the arm lock, eh? It was super easy to do arm locks from close guard. Put it over, please, step over my head. Because people used to be, arm, and afraid, and that's self-fulfilling prophecy. But if I step over, it doesn't really work. The same with foot locks. Because the arm bar doesn't work here. This is the same mechanic as foot locks. If I push through, it works because now I'm going away again. Mm. And it's for everything that's true. So the only thing is keep your weight forward. Now the only problem is if you keep your weight forward, you might get propelled over there and then you're in turtle and that's fine. That's why we need defense. Yeah. So look, now I'm going to be over here. That's the initial entry. Now what I'm looking for is like I'm going to give an oversight of the all of the pressure passing positions. The king of all passes is a double under. Here. If you get there, super good to keep pressure. Quite hard to pass from because it's you can always wobble around left and right and good players are not going to give that. That's the aim. Second one you're going to get is if only gets the wrong things can happen, but one of the other ones is if it gets the foot inside. See, you're going to go for the over under. And it's the one which you realistically are going to get against very good people. That's usually what I'm going to get. And here you can stall him out and teach you the foot will happen. And then every time you mess up, you end up in this spot again where you get one of your other entries. So this is the hub, which where you will fail and again and again and again, but you have to be patient. Now, what can happen for me? Really, can someone put his foot inside my leg, underneath my, for the butterfly, and then it this butterfly, or I call it the double over. You find the double over. Or the bodylock, I call it. Okay, and then, that's all the good sides. Then when it starts to get more fuzzy, who's winning is here. If you start to push my head away, so usually when you're here, you sort of start to push your head away to that side. And then the usual reaction is to start fighting back inside. And that's when you get caught in triangles and other things. So what I do, when I push my head away, see, push my head, I try to accept and go underneath. And these are called the single under. And many people will try to take your back from you and keep attacking you. I think what Raul will do is to put his foot back inside. That's what he did last time.
Yes.
And that makes it super frustrating.
Yeah.
Because then you take it, you go back to the center or whatever, sit here, and then you have to go always into this danger zone yes. again and again and again. We're also dangerous for you, but yes. less because you have good foot locks.
Yeah.
But it depends on what kind of a person you are there and what is your speciality. Yeah? So, then, and that's all the good parts. And when you start to lose a leg, then they have your back. This one is the hub of my game. This is where everybody thinks they won and where they will shoot all their arrows here and where they will lose. If you don't think this is possible, and well, after your video, they have to accept it's possible. If that is what you do is possible, then this is possible for sure. And this is all the upside. Then, if you like to live dangerous, as I do, see, I like to go to triangles. Why do I like to give triangles? Well, because I'm better defending in triangles than I'm better than I'm in defending foot locks. And every single time a person goes to, because if I have to fight that I will keep chasing away, then I have to like get frustrated. So you get him close by giving something sometimes which he cannot resist. So you're here. Then go and then you can go in and start smashing. Of course, you'll leave dangerous. And if you pull away, you get this and you get the legs. But if you stay in, so what I suggest is put a lot of time there. I got like DVDs about this. But to be honest, there is one seminar I put online and there's 900% of the information you're going to need about the triangle. So I'm going to teach about that, but I'm going to teach now about the hub over here. So once you're in, I'm blocking this, and I stay too far away, see, you can do those things, yes, and you can start putting that leg inside as well. This is my enemy number one, 2 feet inside, you cannot pass that. Still in general, if someone puts feet inside, see, I'm not going to try to clean, I'm going to put pressure on them. And I'm not going to try to grab all the time. If you try to grab, and you can think there's things to work with. See here, to honestly speaking, what you have, well, what is the name? It's guard. You have a good guard, mm-hmm. but you cannot really work from there.
Mm-hmm.
And now it depends who's patient. One advantage you have on top is that he has to carry my weight if I put my weight correctly. And his upside is, well, I have to put my weight correctly, and the referee is usually inclined to give the top player the stalling. So what you can do right now, feel this a bit out. Look, put pressure on the feet, don't use your hands. See, and he's gonna, the bottom, you can start to steer a bit. See, start to move the guy also, move around. And usually, go inside and clear. Go back. And start to block. So play a bit from there, don't use your hands. Okay, and then we go into specifics. Over, under, double under, double over, and the fireman. Okay?
So the purpose of the one was the upper one is to get the feet off him, or?
No, look.
What's your purpose now?
Good question. So here my purpose is, look, to take away the will to always try to grab. That's where the problems come from. Look, you're here, mm-hmm. and you play. Look, maybe it goes through my head. Go for a guillotine.
Ah, good.
So basically I'm waiting for my entry to go there. But you can. This is the area where you don't want to be, but where you have to spend the most of the time because here the fight is decided. Mm-hmm. So you play with around, and I like to put my arm inside, push over. I'm never doing this. See, if I push, see, and I try to go, he's already picking inside. But if I go here and I put pressure, now he's going to react to that. See, good. You can start playing with your hands as well. Feet are here, go again, top.
And what you want to get is one in, one out. Mm. That's it. So now I do, but I close my elbow. In the beginning of the question, say, why do you put your hand like that and not like this? Well, because here my elbow flares open. You should keep your elbows closed. Well, let's keep them closed. So here you're, that's a better defense in this case. Okay. Play around a bit with that. Look for the grip. Keep the leg up and see what happens.
Yeah. So I just showed right now that is what you got to do in the end. So what you gotta solve, and I will, because it's impossible for me to teach my whole system of guard passing in the very first class. But what you gotta do, you gotta become a master in this. See? A master in this. In this, and then also the things where it starts to fail. So guillotine defense, when the foot goes out, and later in the game, even when they start to get the feet, that's like my quest now. Can I do the same thing to the upper for the lower body, what I do for the upper body? That's like the niche in jiu-jitsu right now, probably.
Yes.
In some way. And also, never run away from the submission, because that's also what Chaisen is, because when you run away, it's tighter. And it's like the quick answer, but the good answer is get good into the position. And that's what all good guys do, to be honest. They spend a lot of time in the shitty positions, and then you see, they're not too shitty, actually, just to play it well. So,
accept the position.
Yeah. So the closer I get to the game, the less complex it becomes. So now what can happen, for example, one thing that can, what I want to stop, is him getting his leg inside. How do you stop that? Well, I like to, if I could choose where to start, I would probably want to have this here and put my hand in the middle. That's a good start. Now, what can Raul randomly do from here? He can do many things. Yeah. But usually it's going to involve at a lower level, that's the thing, low level do only that, high level do good things, and you can, like, if I fight with you, what makes it very hard, for example, I consider, push my head away please, I consider these things to be low level, but because it is not, because tell you, it's like a beginner will only do that, right? And then you don't do it for a while, and then after a while you add that random gibbery back inside, and that's what makes it like completely random and uncontrollable. That's what makes your game particularly very hard to deal with, you know. So it's like disturbing. Refs is always like slapping the head all the time to make the guy frustrated. So when I'm gonna exaggerate my grip here. So he can do hip escape over there. Yeah, if I skip the other side. Okay, so you want to limit that mobility already. Go back, please. Always keeping this arm in. Okay. Now, I want to already stop the hip escape to that side. What I'm going to do, look, I'm going to exaggerate my grip. See, here. And twist this back. You try to do it now over there. It's possible, but more limited. Just place your hand here. Do the same thing. Not the same. So this is like the how you call it, the cheat code for strong grips. Exaggerate the grip, see, and then twist back. And here I'm going to be still blocking. Now, Raul will start to push my head away. I like to use my elbows to block and more get up. Or pushing away also helps, especially for people who like this kind of games. So what I like to do, I put my forehead. Well, I don't get it already, but I'm aiming for this. And if I don't give it, don't try to get inside, because when you get inside, you will deflect. So how you deal with pressure? How you deal with bullies? You bully them harder. So push my head, please. Yeah, keep insisting. Don't move away to try to get your head in. So he has to move. And that's not fun for your face, but it's a price you'll have to pay. Boom. Now, so that's a whole game you have to play. Very many minutes. And I can tell you, most of the time, you will not have to do that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So put your forehead here on the floor, on his chest. Now, from here, look, Raul can always try to start getting up, try to run away from me, see, and getting back up. And you don't want to do that. I consider Jitsu as a wrestling match. I want to keep his shoulder on the floor. So go back with me, please. So what I do here, I exaggerate, pull back, put my arm, put my forehead. And now from here, I'm going to put pressure on my arm and on my shoulder, put my toes, put pressure everywhere, and I start to put my hip up. And that's where I want to be. And here, the first thing I want to do is like, make sure you cannot do extreme motions. So extreme motions will be very slowly. Hip escape to this side, please.
This side? Yeah,
very slowly. I'll put a bit more pressure over there. If you escape the other side, I will circle back. So my goal now is to keep you on the shoulder, and I don't want that hip to go far out. What adds to that is that I'm going to make you do a split. So keep tightly. So if I'm here and I put pressure here, it's not super uncomfortable. It's not that comfortable either. You feel like you're pretty flexible. Yeah. There's people who only go into trouble from just being here. Yeah. And if I do this, look, if I make a split to you. Yeah. So if I put pressure, you don't want to rough it, but if you do this pressure here, look, now it becomes quite uncomfortable and you will start to put your hips away. Okay, so go back to this. So now, for example, one way to deal with that is to make a hip escape to this side. And it becomes less uncomfortable. Yeah. So if I do, you make a hip escape.
So this side?
I put a bit more pressure. Uh-huh. You go to the other side. Mm. So you keep him there until he exaggerates his motion. So I exaggerate, pull back, going in. Boom. Push pressure first, then go up. And now we play the game with the arm. He puts his foot inside again. Boom. Mm. Put your foot on my chest. So you stay here. He pushes through. You need to get it out again, see? Maybe put the foot on the chest here. Okay, always staying here to be safe. Always clear that foot. Yeah, so there is no clear answer. You just play a lot of things and you will start to recognize opportunities. Now, actually, play a bit from there. Feel it out. Try to keep inside control with his arm. Yeah? Sometimes also I will start, for example, grab my shoulder, try to attack my arm. See this? It's a gift. Get for it? As long as you don't put yourself out of balance. You keep here, attack it, please, though. That's usually...
No, this is going to be a pass.
Yeah. Exactly. Mm. If you want to commit to an upper body attack, yeah. I can start wiring you out. That's what you want to do.
Is that also why you keep it still like that late? Because it's like...
No,
it's already giving it here, but you're still unsustained.
It's like saying this in boxing. Eh? This is not a very good stance. It doesn't block anything. But it's the average of all defense. If I just do this, if I just put my hand like that, that I will give a hook and I have to travel far. If you're here, everything is... So this is the same thing. It's like the middle of everything. It's not perfect for anything, but it's close to
it. On average, it's the fastest.
Just like a turtle. It's the worst defense in total, but it's close to everything.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's the idea. Okay? Try. And where we will go right now, it's endless from there, yeah? But look, so we can give some pointers. Go look. Look, what I'm going to do today, actually, is this. Look, Raul knows all these things. I think even a blue belt these days, who trains 2 years, mostly knows basically all the passes. So this is going to give you the tools a bit to start exploring this area from the game yourself. So I just can tell you, if you spend enough time here, then random stuff will happen. Sometimes you will die. And then you can spend more time until you don't die, or you can spend more time in prevention. This is the prevention. Yeah. Okay. So once I get close here, you have to know. Most of the problems will come from this leg. If he pulls my arm inside, for example, he gets his arm across, that's a bigger as a problem. Eh? If he gets my arm over here, close the triangle, that is not really a problem. It starts, if I keep my weight, relax please, if I keep my weight here, nothing really happened here, it's just a different phase of the over-under pass, which is slightly more dangerous. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Now, when I'm here, close, exactly, pull it back. The main thing I'm looking for is that even I keep my elbow very far open because I don't want that leg to be coming inside. If you want to catch my leg, catch underneath my arm. If you want to catch my arm, it's hard, see? Here, I can still hide it, and if you go with this arm underneath, I can just twist it back and go for the thing. What you're going to see in this game is very many times, man, especially if the guy is good, flexible, everything together, see? That you're going to occasionally go 3 steps forward, 3 steps back. But you wire him out. At the same time, this works into your favor. Because the referee says, good game, no staller. And I listen to the breathing. And I always go, and if I, after 5 minutes of fighting, on a 6 minutes match, all that happened is back and forth, but I used to like, okay, 0-0, bah, 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 bah. Who's going to win the match by decision? Maybe me. Maybe him. That depends. But I only need one mistake to where he cannot come back from. Yeah? And a good referee to be able to read the fight properly. So you're gonna exaggerate and pull back. That's the first thing. Now you wanna stop him from I wanna keep the pressure here. See, try to move a bit, look.
After a while, they will get frustrated here. Now, they will start working with this leg. So what is one of the things that can happen? See, yeah? Sometimes I put this leg, try to put the leg in your neck. Oh, this is good. Yeah, but let's now see. Fully here. Go back, see? Bad thing to do, but bad things happen. So when you're here, put pressure, like go, and boom.
They start to go for the double under. Now, double under does not works the same way as I put it. This is not really good. Because he can, the center is very random. Yeah. So, but if I can get the leg over here, this is in general a good thing. So I exaggerate your grip over the hip, close your elbow. If I gave a normal double under class, I would start from here. But since it's more specific, see we're here, he puts the leg in my neck, boom, close. Go over, close the elbow. Very important, keep your weight forward. To the point you're even going here. Okay, now, specific to this, look. If I will get his foot out over my head, see, you will pummel it. Well, this is very
bad.
Yeah, but how would you do it? If you get your foot over.
Over your head.
Put it there. So not always a bad thing. Put it over. No, stay here. Put your foot over my head and open your knee.
Yeah, I would flare this.
Yeah, that's what I meant. See here and now. Well, I can still continue on this.
Yeah.
This is even something I never thought about. I know I do it, I never thought of it. But basically, you put the foot in your neck, you go over the hip, see, and close your elbow. So don't even grab, just do this. Because if I grab, my elbow opens. I'm going to be here. Pressure forward, okay. If I will push this hip up, keep going forward. Then you can always advance. See, if he tries to run away, try to go faster. And my head, go back please, I always try to trap his leg. The big mistake most people make with the over-under, that they try too much to pass the leg away. And then he's out. I try to error on that side. The perfect thing is in the middle. But the middle, you always make a mistake if you go to, it's very hard to balance on a circus ball. So I put myself, sorry, man, a bit more on this side. Now look, if Raul gets his head out over there, all we get is you go back to the hub where we already were. However, if I put myself more on this side, his head will go out there. Go, defend. And this is way harder to recover from. And still, it can still happen, but you want to be more on that side. So I'm here. You made a mistake of putting that arm in my neck. Go over, close the elbow, lean in. And I try to really immobilize that leg. Keep going forward. The foot here can also come inside. Don't try to remove it. Keep the pressure. Don't try to fight the leg because it gives space. So bring your arm inside, even passing to the other side, doesn't matter. You should keep your weight forward. And I try to pass the guard more to this side. Let's say it doesn't move at all. I will try to go underneath, see? And little by little, see? Head opening, the elbow, and pass. Now, what is another thing that can happen? Sometimes from here, he starts to grab my leg. And that's a gift. Because then, a few things can happen. He goes deeper, and I will try to start fighting for the from the north-south. Or, what else can happen? If I can get the head, and it's game over. So we'll explore this pass. The end game, which I would start from, is from here, go forward, bring the hip up, and spend a lot of time from here. So you try to get out now, please. Go. And a little bit move the knee up. And even here, look, put your feet on the floor. Now you can start escaping right away. But if I keep the hip up, put your hip up, please. Up high. See, try to escape. Now he's actually giving me something. As he escapes, I already get my knee inside. So I just want to prolong the suffering as long as I can.
Yes.
And after this side, where in your game are you? If you want to make it easiest, you start from here. Shift the head. Go here. Yeah. Secondly, can be inside from here. Keep your weight forward. The entry is going to happen from here. Okay? Blank. Go. The question was?
Yeah, so when you have double under and you don't feel that he's going one or the other way, what
to do? Yes. Well, there is four answers I can give to that.
Okay.
Put your head in the middle.
Okay.
One, first and foremost, you always have to keep your weight forward if you want to pass on one guard. Because if I put my weight here, start to walk away, you're faster than me. If I put my weight here, walk away, I'm always going to keep up. And pressure goes forward. If you see passing like this, if you want to practice standing on a big circus ball, then the goal is to be in the middle. But it's quite hard. And every time you fall from the ball, you have to get up to practice again. Guard pressing is easy. Guard pressing is like this. See, you can always, my balance is forward, but I can use a person for my, for a, you know?
Base.
It's an imbalance, but you know where is your imbalance. If you're in the middle, yeah, then everything is dangerous. Here, backward doesn't exist.
Okay.
So, go down. Now, so, okay, we're here. I'm going to look for weaknesses in your... That's actually a good way to put it. You put pressure, and you start looking for weaknesses in the structures, like cracks in the dam. Okay. So, keep the hands. It's like, I can talk 10 hours about this alone. Mm-hmm. But the basic thing, if I get my... This is not the best one, actually, but if you get it, see, here. Now, for example, one mistake can happen. Try to break my grips. Go again. Ah, that was better. Okay. Then you look at, catch my hands. And you start to look at my hands.
Yeah, I
look. Look. Yeah. Go with your both hands. So then you get stacked.
Mm, right.
Now if you run away fast, go. You still break, but we're still here. And I'm always gonna keep that pressure. Firing. And we go again. Now another thing that also happens, you put a bit of pressure, push me away with your hip. Push me.
Like that. Go.
Yeah. Now, what is hard for me? Put your chin up. No, that's your chin down. Put your head on the floor. Yes, good job. Yeah. Now, keep doing that. The rock bottom. Make a hole in your back. Oh, right. Relax. Patience. Yeah, here. Whoa, that's already a completely different structure. Now, break my grips. Nope. Put your elbows on the floor. Open your elbows. Don't touch my hands.
Wait.
It's Corona, man. There's a virus there. Don't put your elbows on the floor. Here. Keep your hands here. Yeah. And don't touch them with your hands. Here.
So now I open your hands.
Listen. Thank you very much. You already did it. Now, this was strength. Now, I'm going to do the same thing. Put your elbows on the floor.
Okay.
Because do you want to break my grip? That's another question. You don't want to break my grip.
I don't know.
I'm going to tell you why. Open your elbows. Bend your wrists.
Like this?
No. Yes. Put pressure on your elbows. Yeah. See, now you have 2 feet. Put your elbows on your feet. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So now, don't explode. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
Put some tension on your knees open. Yes. That's already tight. Yeah. But you want me to be tired, but if this happens, then it resets. So you want me to hang on for dear life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You want to create a feeling of someone hanging on the cliff.
Someone like almost ready.
Yeah. Give me some hope. Well, depends who you're fighting with. Me, it would be probably a better option just to not do that. But as a basic answer for everybody, yes. You open your knees, good. Yeah. Now start to walk away. Yeah. Now, if you get your feet inside my hip, don't look. Inside, this is already good, but inside, put your feet inside. Now make a sit up. Oh, do not get out.
No.
Just make a sit up. Do what I said. Make a straight sit up.
I'm not sure how to do
just
it.
Just a normal sit up. Like
ab crunch.
Do not move your feet. Yeah, here. Now put your pressure forward and put your butt backwards. Relax. Don't break my shoulders. Mm-hmm. Put your both feet in. You can treat this. You can do basic butterfly sweeps from here.
Okay.
With my arm moves out, so you don't want me to stay there. The big story of all the defensive jiu-jitsu and everything else, and getting good at everything, stay there and don't break grips. Everything is okay. Yeah? Come back in. This was the worst idea for me. But usually, you're going to have like a battle back and forth between that.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm going to look for imbalances.
Mm-hmm.
So often, I will not go for this because I will lose it. If I get it great, but usually I will end up with this. So now, make rock bottom. Then I will look for another imbalance. It will be the wobble.
Mm-hmm.
If I am allowed to do this, I guess I'm putting pressure.
Mm-hmm.
This triggers you have to go to the other side. Oh, thank you very much, but I said the other side. Yeah, so now I go there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, the very good players will still cancel out that also. And now the third one comes, and it's never a guarantee, but it's always layer after layer. So then you do this. Keep your leg tighter.
Mm-hmm.
I will squeeze. Relax your leg, please. Often people forget to relax their leg. I can do like a kimura on the leg.
Mm-hmm.
And you squeeze this, see, I try to push your elbow, push my elbow.
This one?
Yeah, just push it without moving the hip. Hard.
Yeah.
Now, what I usually do, push my elbow, mash my elbow, and put your hip up. No, that's not what I meant. It's weird, but okay, it can happen, I suppose. Push hip into the air, and look over your shoulder, and start to break, and then it can start going in again.
Yeah.
And then it brings us again here.
Right.
And I keep pushing all those options to each other and always, every once in a while, and back up over here.
Yeah.
Basic idea of the over-under pass. Relax, just go in. You just want to get ahead. Keep your pressure forward. Make the guy suffer until he picks a side. Pick a side. There. You can pick a side. Try to escape. Good. Now, don't pass here. Keep your weight here. Yeah. And then start to twist the hip.
and make him suffer here forever until he gives you something. For example, turn to the knees. It's like a good moment to attack here. Too late.
Yeah.
You have to attack him in the angle. Play with these things. Go.
Thanks. Thank you for your question.
I want to pay attention. Look at my feet. Okay, that's it. Ready? Go. Stop. You see what happens? Saw what happens? What do my feet do? They always move.
Yeah.
That's random jitter that I cannot explain. I can explain every moment why I do it. But this will take us, okay, we can make a full analysis, and this will lead us to people listening to me talking for 50 hours, and it will not bring you anywhere close to a solution. It's just simple. Balancing on a ball is super easy. Keep your weight in the middle. I said keep your weight in the middle. It's easier to follow the balls. Just keep your weight in the middle, you stupid white adult. I was like that, eh? And then the person gets scared, and what will happen? He will stop practicing and he will not get it. So just go on the damn ball. You're my ball from here. Lay down. Okay. Guidelines. Keep your weight forward. Don't fall. Huh? Don't put your weight, well, don't do many things, I suppose. Huh? And here, you have to be a nice ball. Because don't be the ball. Don't be the coach that comes here and kicks the ball away. No. If your weight is perfect, hop, you can do that. You just land on your feet, but good luck. So here... Look, I cannot make random mistakes. I cannot make default mistakes. For example, it's a default mistake. And when you're advanced, you can make default mistakes. Because if you push me away, that might be something you want to do. In the beginning, you keep your weight in the middle and you start to work. What is a very bad default mistake? Push my hand away. No connection. So I have to be able to try to get out. Reasonably well keep some degree of control. Just like if you want to do a, I'm not going to leave it too far. So I'm just going to keep it connected. Where my hands are, doesn't matter. I often don't fight with grips. I just curl around. And then if you want to make it easier, you go to the end game first. And you start working from here, and you are like a nice ball who moves at 10%, and I'm going to just try to keep you stuck. Maybe put your foot over, good. And then I can start allowing things that happen. I don't care where the feet are. And that, look, one basic thing, for example, we did with Rahul today, was you cross your feet. Wait. So stuff like that will happen. When you're, for example, here. And, I don't know this. I'm going to go backwards. I'm going to go back in. Same thing happens. There is no dead end. Well, there are sometimes doors are closed, and what you do when the door is closed? You keep knocking until they open. If you keep ringing someone's bell at night, they will open. We get frustrated. And then you put your weight, and then same thing. And now it's his goal. The goal of the bottom player is to not get tired and use my overcommitting to his advantage. Yes? As a basic level. My goal is to keep my weight in the middle. Don't overcommit and wire him out with my weight. And that's all there is. There's no risk to it. And after you master that, then starts pushing my head away. Then you start to do the random jitter we cannot really explain. Yeah. Pushing the head is a very bad idea. But it's not if you just do it like that, then it's a good idea all of a sudden, if you know why you do it. Yeah? So let me continue with something. Rahul, please. So look, very basically what will happen when you go for the double underpass, you have those the few methods to go in, and some will never work, and then random stuff happens. So when we go back to here, so he starts to walk away. Yeah? I will never want to have the feet inside. I'm going to quickly mention it, but I'm not going to go fully through this over. It's not always part of the system here, but if you're here, if one foot comes inside, put your hip to that side. And keep your weight forward. Because if you put your weight backwards, it will come on top. Even if you put your weight forward, it will still be able to come on top.
Yeah.
Sometimes. It comes on top, come top. But you can use a moment to spin through and reset. This happens all the time. Advantage, because IBJF said so. But here, put both feet inside. As a trainer partner, don't aggressively stretch your legs because you will break your arms. Now, I've never been tapped in my life from here, never in my life, but
put pressure between your feet, then you start to, again, lean sideways and start to work here. And this gives you, again, a possible entry for the attack. Don't overcommit. Be here, put pressure again. Yeah. It's always like dancing. Attack, question and answer. He doesn't make a mistake, I'm not going to make a mistake. That's the goal. Now, what I'm looking for in this, another checkpoint we can add is, okay, the foot comes, I come back here, so the feet start to, like, stretch your legs, for example. Stretch your legs. Now, make a, open your feet and stretch your legs. You put them on the floor. I can never do the double under pass. So now I'm going to do the very basic over under, but don't act, okay? So here I will put my arm out, see, and put my pressure on top. Head over, and I can start walking. Good. Most ideal part for me, what would happen here is if you make a hip escape to that side. Okay, then I can start controlling the position over here. And this is usually where it all leads to. Go one step back. Again, this is very rare you will make a huge mistake like that, but like split seconds. So here, I start to stretch the leg more, or maybe half-half, can also do that later. So stretch your legs now, good as the first entry. So get your arm out, put pressure on the leg. And also, actually the head goes over, push over, walk to the middle, put yourself down. Good. Now let's imagine this is the one thing you can do first. Second step, usually legs are not going to be fully straight, they're going to be like slightly, like, so this is going to be a battle also, but now we skip that battle. You stretch your leg a little bit, freeze. That's what's going to happen. So now you put your elbow, push yourself up, you go over. And here at this point, there will still often hip escape to that side. See, and that's where you play your heel, walk to the center. How to balance this position? If I go here, you can push me over. Here, rotate your belly. Go back. It's if I rotate with him. If I want to stay on top, windshield wiper, counter rotation. Elbow, push my head. Would you do a red hero?
Yeah, this.
I expected the foot to come in my face, but
no.
Basically the same thing. You want to square up again, yes?
Yeah.
Good. That can happen. Let me go again. What usually happens here on competition? Lay down, please. Luckily for me, 99% of the time this happens. I'm here, they lay down and start pushing this away. Mm-hmm. And this exact same thing was, no, this actually is still good. We come in, start pushing me away and try to get your legs out without, so move your shoulders away. And try to get your legs out.
Yeah.
I cannot. It's the same mistake I said.
Yeah.
But it happens. Like, even a black belt, I had it happen. I tried to, because people don't put themselves there often, and they just focus on the winning part. Once again, so we're here. Get over, you spread the legs. Bam. So as we're here, hip escapes. Whoop. That's true. Connect. No move. But what Raul wants to do, he wants to, for example, rotate to his knees. If I give this leg, now he stops. And my goal is here is to slowly walk in and, little by little, convince you to go lay on your back. Not at a single moment will I ever try to pass, because if I pass, he goes up again. And this is with Raul, but do this with this is your best aspect of the game. Try to do that with if you do that with a good wrestler, they stand back up and go here. So heavier people, more wrestling-based people, that will defend turtle, like pre-dust standing up. I do also more with judo, mess around in the middle, because middleweight people, like I try to do games that I can do with everybody. If you're very heavy, you can always stand up, usually, to get lighter people. If you're very light, you can never do that. If you're in the middle, we have to mess with both aspects a little bit, okay? So, it's clear or want me to show again?
One more time.
Okay, over here please. Have a look on that side. Also want to see one. Want to see?
Okay.
Better to watch for my feet. It's a quick transition, but over here, you stretch your leg out, please go up. Boom, I put my elbow inside. So I put pressure here, and put your foot on the foot on the floor. As the hip escapes, you have to go over and pass through. This is exactly the position I need, please. As long as he keeps looking away, I have to keep looking away as well. Now imagine he keeps rotating to his knees. This clearing grip is always a good option. Go back, please. Better you get the better after. But imagine he doesn't clear the grip as he keeps rotating. So this gives you a very good way to attack the back, because he's out of balance. strips the grip, full reset. If they break your grips, it's over. So,
rotate again, try to go for my grip. So you start to insist there, blah, blah, blah. Then we probably have to fight more here, and that leads to back attacks. My main aim, and what most people do, they look in your eyes, they keep more pushing you away, then your aim is to go close, stay up even, please, to be here, and just slowly start bringing them to the floor. And you fight from here. You stall them out until they start, until you get them on both shoulders, they bring the leg back, step over, and start fighting from the mount, for the mount. Okay?
This is the main idea. Let's go.
Yep.
5 minutes.
Some people need to eat.
Of course, yeah.
So, look. The classical way to view position is, you go back, please?
Yeah.
A long time ago, we would say this. Back take, both feet inside, arm down here. Little by little, we started to learn that this is not all that we need. It can also be this. We notice a lot of variability in the arms. Yes? And also we realize that feet don't have to be here. They can be outside. Probably better is this, with the exception that sometimes you get footlock if you're not wary. But overall, this is better. Now, if you think about this, what is the moment? So every single time I'm here and Raul controls my both hands, and I start to attack, I'm like always gonna lose terrain on this moment. Yes? So the best way for me to do is always when Raul tries to escape, that is the moment I should start. Here's where the mistakes happen on both of our sides. If you know this, what is the ideal, what do you need to have before you open your hands and start attacking? What is the minimum you need? Have perfect leg control, whatever that may mean for you. For me, if I have this, see, now I'm allowed to even fight without hands and I can keep the game going before I can attack. Everybody agree on this?
Mm-hmm.
Good. But we don't get points here from IGF, so it's a bad position. Well, no, you need that. It just, IGF is running, the general view is running centuries behind. It doesn't matter. It's about control and about submission. And the points is just something to make it interesting, I suppose, but I'm completely against it. Like, I think there's very few guards matches. Put three referees, fight. Everybody gives points on the fight, and let's see what happens. If there's no submission, we're going to have shitty decisions. Yeah? Now we have shitty decisions and shitty matches. Now we only have sometimes shitty decisions. That's fine. Mm. Now, mount, the same look. In mount, we're not that far yet. This is the equivalent of having both feet inside of the closed guard. So, look at, and now I'm going to still, this is still obvious. Put my feet here, good control can happen. Okay? And now imagine things like this. Touch your belly. I have my feet here. Full belly. Okay. And now turn to your back. Because you give me slow mo. Look. Arguably, this is a better control for me if I combine it with a grip. This is a better control for me than a mount.
Yeah.
But no point. So I'm gonna go here and now he's free to move again. Mm-hmm. So what I do often when I'm fighting is I will take the points because I want them, but I will not go for it before I win the arm battle. So then it gets to, it's like a pass where you have, for example, have both feet in, and I'm here, and I could slide if I wanted to. But now I have to scramble for the fight again. So I often do, especially on training competition, I sometimes have to get what you can get depending on the time. But I will be here, see, I will start to fight for my grips. And typically, when I have everything perfect here, then I will still make him lose a bit and suffer and fight the losing battle, which you only make you tired. And you can pass, but then I'm thinking, why should we pass? You can actually skip it all the way and go to mount. But even here, this mount is way better and way safer against Raul. This is one step extra, 1% safer. It would be an idiot to go here. Oh, so, there we go again. So that's what I will only do if I have like perfect grip control on top. So try to look away from those points. Well, I don't think it's a problem here because you're not really IBGF minded in any case, I suppose. So keep away. Sorry?
Not yet.
It's the good thing with Jitsu is there is many different rule sets. And that's the strength. You can test it in different circumstances. So hi guys, look, you still have time or have to stop?
5 more minutes.
5 minutes. I will give the main idea. The best I just showed are the main ideas.
Then the rules. After a while, you will end up. So when you start spreading your legs, see, you're here, you go over, then up in your over under. Main point of this hand over here, put it inside your knee. Yeah. So try. So this is very reasonable to keep control. Every time I push your hand away, yeah, don't fight it. Push, accept it. Push my head away. You rotate away. Because when I'm losing pressure on my head, I gain the pressure over here. Okay? You push my head to the other side. Well, you can make it, stop it by keeping your weight more on the error on that side. I play a lot with these things. I have balance on my head. Even go to the point of here, push me over. And that, if you do this, then you get better when it does happen and you didn't shoot it. Yeah? Okay, then.
What I'm aiming for, if this is the wiring outside. This is, if I bring the weight here, I will start to walk over that leg, occasionally get my foot out, keep walking. I will never try to move it away. I'll wait and I keep walking. He moves away, I can step over since start to walk with the leg to the other side. Every time I'm here, I want to control both legs. If I'm a wrestler, he will get up here. So the only pass on this side, if he makes a mistake of hip escaping to that side. And they do this, they give you the pass for free. Same applies for the leg drag. Last part, which I didn't get to, is if you're here, then start to push your head away on the side. Go underneath and spend a lot of time here in this position. Again, push my head away, okay, good, yeah. The hardest part is always if you try to escape, and it will always be a reset. So it's like a bait, you want them to attack it. So for example, go for armor. Let's spin over, catch the foot, pitch through, and this gives you an option again for the pass or for wiring out. He goes for my back. Yeah, good. If you need to zip, often happens, and it becomes just a deep half guard. But no points yet. You're still in. Well, people say, it's bad at the back. So this is bad, and then this is supposed to be front top, and this is supposed to be good then if you play half guard. It's just the same position, just from a different angle and perspective, yeah. So that's the main things. And I'm going to add like the triangle defense and well, everything. And start putting things. Okay. And to conclude, so I just showed you my favorite hub to start the fight. And actually the big part, because it's all the same passes. There's nothing new there. But what you should aim for, you can use mine, or maybe choose your favorite way to start every fight. If I do gi, I only have one goal. I want to have this hand on that color. And it's very applicable goals. If you start to ask for more, or if you... I read one time, the more options you... So if you have one situation, when you have three options, you're the worst fighter than the guy with only one option. Because the one option guy will not waste time, and the three option guy will always be... That's apparently there's no research about that. Mm-hmm.
So the duality of choice.
Cool.
Yes. The fact that you have to choose, it's also a split second longer in your
Yeah, life. Exactly. That was it.
And if you have no choice, that's all you do. Like all I do is leglocks. Then apparently you save time.
Yeah. Any questions about anything? Nothing else? Good, that's it.
Right. Thank you.
Cool,
you shake the man's hand, man.